him from ourselves knowledge.
وهما على ظهر السفينة.
Both of them on board of the ship.
جاء طائر.
A bird came.
وأخذ من البحر قطرة.
And he took from the sea just a droplet.
فسأل الخضر موسى عليه السلام.
So الخضر asked موسى عليه الصلاة والسلام.
ترى كم أخذ هذا الطائر من هذا البحر؟
He asked how much did this bird take away from this the water of the sea.
قال لم يأخذ شيئا بالنسبة لما في البحر.
Nothing compared to the sea, what the water of the sea.
فقال ما علمي وعلمك وعلم الناس أجمعين.
He said my knowledge, your knowledge, and the knowledge of all people gathered all together.
في علم الله.
Compared to the knowledge of Allah.
صفة العلم لله.
This is now the attribute of knowledge of Allah.
إلا كما أخذ هذا الطائر من هذا البحر.
Is exactly like except that it is like what this bird has taken from that water.
فالخالق عليم.
So the creator is knowledgeable.
والمخلوق عليم.
The created is knowledgeable.
والمشترك العلم.
The attribute here, the word that is shared, is knowledge.
والخالق له صفة العلم.
The creator has the attribute of knowledge.
والمخلوق له صفة العلم.
The created has the attribute of knowledge.
والمشترك اللفظ, لفظ الصفة فقط.
And what is shared between both is the word itself, the word that indicates the attribute.
والطريقة الثالثة في الرد على المشبهة.
The third way now to refute those who liken Allah to His creation.
مقارنة الصفة بالذات والذات بالصفة.
Comparing the entity to the attribute and the attribute comparing it to the entity.
فنقول لمن يشبه.
We say to the one who liken Allah to his creation.
أتعتقد أن الله تبارك وتعالى له ذات؟
Do you believe that Allah has an entity, an essence?
وأن ذاته لا تشبه ذات المخلوقين.
And that his entity, his that, his essence do not resemble that the entity of the created beings.
فكيف تثبت صفة لله عز وجل كصفة المخلوقين؟
So then, if you affirm that about the entity, then how is it that you are affirming for Allah an attribute like the attributes of the created beings?
والكلام في الصفات هو الفرع عن الكلام في الذات.
Speaking about the attributes of Allah is a branch, branching off of talking about the entity of Allah, that of Allah.
فإذا كان ذاته لا تشبه ذات المخلوقين.
So if you are affirming an entity, a that, that do not resemble the entities of the created beings.
كذلك صفاته لا تشبه صفات المخلوقين.
Likewise, his attributes do not resemble the attributes of the created beings.
فعلمه لا يشبه علم المخلوقين.
So his knowledge do not resemble the knowledge of the created beings.
كما أن ذاته العليمة لا تشبه ذات المخلوقين العليمة.
Exactly like his knowledgeable entity do not resemble at all the knowledgeable entity of the created beings.
والطريقة الرابعة والأخيرة.
The fourth way and the last way in refuting those who liken Allah to His creation.
الرد على المشبهة.
To refute them.
ببعض المخلوقات نفسها.
With some of the created things themselves.
فنحن نعتقد.
So we believe.
نحن والمشبهة على حد سواء.
We and those who liken Allah to His creation, we believe both the same way.
أن كل حي من المخلوقين
that every living creature of the created beings
له روح وله بدن.
Every created being has a soul and has a body.
ولا يكون حيا إلا إذا اجتمعت الروح والبدن.
And that thing will not be a living thing except when the soul and the body are gathered together.
ونحن والمشبهون جميعا
we and those who liken Allah to his creation, both of us,
نعرف, نعرف كثيرا عن البدن.
We know a lot about the body.
ونحن والمشبهون جميعا.
And we and those who liken to Allah to his creatures, we all of us together on the same level.
لا نعلم عن الروح إلا قليلا.
We do not know about the soul, the spirit, except very little.
ويسألونك عن الروح قل الروح من أمر ربي.
They ask you about the soul or the spirit, say the soul or the spirit is from the command of my Lord.
وما أوتيتم من العلم إلا قليلا.
And you have not been given of the knowledge except very little.
فإذا كان الإنسان المخلوق الحي,
so if the human being, the created being, the living being,
لا نستطيع أن نعرف كنها حياته,
we do not know the reality, the essence of his living, of his life,
بل جزءا من كنه حياته وهي الروح,
rather we do not know part of the essence of his life and that is the spirit, the soul.
فكيف نشبه الله عز وجل بخلقه ونحن لا نعرف عن كنهه؟
How is it that we are likening Allah, then you are likening Allah to his creation when we do not know about his essence سبحانه وتعالى.
فعجزنا عن معرفة كنه المخلوق.
So the fact that we are unable to know the essence and the reality of the created being,
وهو بين جنبات كل واحد منا,
while this soul which we don't know much about it, it's within the body of each one of us,
أولى بعجزنا عن معرفة كنه الله تبارك وتعالى.
This makes us more unable to know how the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala,
حتى نشبهه بخلقه,
in a way for you to end up likening Allah to his creation.
هذا القسم الأول.
This is the first group.
القسم الثاني,
second group,
خلطوا بين نفي التشبيه,
they mixed up between negating the likening Allah to his creation,
وعندهم بعض التشبيه,
and they have some of likening Allah to his creation.
وهم أقرب ما يكونوا إلى أهل السنة.
And they are the closest to be from the groups to أهل السنة.
ولكنهم ليسوا سلفيين محض, أهل السنة محض.
But they are not pure followers of the Salaf. They are not pure أهل السنة.
فما وافقوا فيه السلف في إثبات صفات الله عز وجل,
so whatever they agreed with the pious predecessors in affirming the attributes,
بغير تشبيه,
without likening Allah to his creation,
فنحن معهم فيها.
We agree with them on that.
وما أثبتوا فيها من صفات وفيها بعض التشبيه,
and whatever they affirmed of the attributes and they have some likening of Allah to his creation,
رد عليهم بما رد على الطائفة الأولى,
then we reject them in the same way we rejected the first group, reject what they say exactly like we rejected what the first group said.
هؤلاء الذين أثبتوا ظاهر أسماء الله وصفاته في القرآن والسنة,
those who affirmed the apparent attributes of Allah in the book and the sunnah,
على ظاهرها,
according to their apparent meaning.
القسم الثاني,
second group,
وهم الذين قالوا أن هذه الأسماء الأسماء والصفات,
those who said that those names and attributes,
أو هذه الألفاظ,
عفوا شيخنا, المجموعة الأولى مجموعتين وهذه
وهذه مجموعات مجموعتين.
This is the second group now, which there are two groups.
الذين يقولون بأن هذه الألفاظ غير ظاهرة.
Those who say that those
ظاهرها غير مراد.
This group that say that those wordings of the texts, their apparent meaning is not intended.
نبقى على المثال الأول حتى ما نضيعهم.
We stay with the same example so we don't get lost.
العلم,
knowledge,
والعليم,
the all knowledgeable.
فقالوا أن العليم,
they said that the knowledgeable,
لا يراد ظاهره,
the apparent meaning of it is not intended,
وأنه يعلم كل شيء,
that he knows everything,
ويوصف بأنه العليم,
that he is described that he is,
ويسمى بأنه العليم,
that he is called with the name of knowledgeable,
الذي يعلم ما كان وما يكون وما سيكون,
the one who knows what was, what will, what is being and what will be,
وأنه علمه كامل في الماضي والمستقبل والحاضر,
that his knowledge is complete and perfect in the past, present and future.
فالله يعلم في عقيدة السلف.
So Allah, in the belief of the pious predecessors,
ليس عنده ماض ومستقبل وحاضر,
He doesn't have past, present, and future.
بينما عند هؤلاء الذين يقولون بأنه بأن اللفظ غير مراد ظاهره.
While those who claim that the apparent meaning is not intended.
عندهم ماض وحاضر ومستقبل.
They have past, present, and future in terms of knowledge.
فنحن في معتقدنا في صفة العلم.
So in our belief regarding the knowledge of Allah.
أن علم الله عز وجل الماضي والحاضر والمستقبل
that the knowledge of Allah عز وجل past, present and future
كعلم أحدنا بهذه الأصابع الثلاثة ينظر إليها
like our knowledge of these three fingers looking at them.
فهل يفترق علمه عن هذا عن هذا عن هذا
is our knowledge different of this finger is it different from our knowledge of this finger from our knowledge in the third finger while looking at them now
مع أنها ثلاثة
although they are three
لكن العلم بها واحد
but knowing them is just one and the same
ولله المثل الأعلى
and to Allah belongs the best example
فالعلم عند الله عز وجل
The knowledge of Allah عز وجل
ليس فيه ماض وحاضر ومستقبل
has no past, present and future
فالذين قالوا بأن هذه الألفاظ ليست مرادة على ظاهرها
those who said that those wordings the meanings of them are not intended according to the apparent meaning
أو أن بعضها مراد
or that some are intended
وبعضها غير مراد
and some are not intended
أو ما ثبت في القرآن منها نثبته
or they said What is affirmed in the Quran, we affirm it.
وما جاء في غيرها من النصوص لا نثبته.
And what has come of the attributes in other than the Quran, then we don't affirm it.
أو انحرفوا عن معنى العلم إلى معنى الإحاطة مثلا.
Or they deviated from the meaning of knowledge. They drifted and they explained it as encompassing.
أو عن معنى العلم إلى معنى الرؤية.
Or they drifted from, deviated from the knowledge of from the meaning of knowledge to the meaning of seeing.
أو عن معنى العلم إلى معنى المعرفة.
Or from the meaning of knowledge to the meaning of being informed.
يعلم بمعنى يعرف.
He knows meaning. He is acquainted or he is informed.
علم بمعنى عرفة.
He knew, meaning he was informed.
فهذه كلها معان قالوا بأن هذا يعني في إثبات اللفظة لفظة العلم أو العليم.
In terms of affirming the word knowledge or knowledgeable.
غير مراد لظاهره أو مراد بعضه.
They said either the apparent meaning is not intended or they said part of it is intended.
وغير مراد بعضه.
And part of it is not intended.
يعلم ما في الأرحام.
He knows what is in the wombs.
العلم بما في الأرحام.
Knowing what is in the wombs.
من خصائص الله عز وجل.
Is from the special characteristics of Allah سبحانه.
في اعتقاد أهل السنة والجماعة.
According to the people of Sunnah and
Jama'ah. السلفيين.
The people of following the Salaf.
يعلم ما في الأرحام علما تفصيليا.
He knows what is in the wombs of the mothers. In detail.
ذكر أو أنثى.
Male or female.
أبيض أم أحمر.
White or red.
ماذا سيكون حاله في المستقبل؟
What is his condition will be in the future?
كيف سيكون من أهل الجنة أو من أهل النار؟
How he will be from the people of paradise or the people of the fire?
ماذا سيكون من عمله في الدنيا؟
What will be his actions in this worldly life?
هذا كله عند أهل السنة والجماعة وارد فيه ويعلم ما في الأرحام.
All of this is included according to Ahl al-Sunnah in the statement he knows as in the Quran he knows what is in the wombs
وغيره طبعا
and other than that of course
بينما هؤلاء الذين يقولون أنه غير ظاهر
while those who claim that this the intended meaning or the apparent meaning is not intended
يقتصرون على بعض ما في هذه المعاني
they restrict themselves to some of these meanings
فهؤلاء الذين قالوا أنه غير ظاهر.
So those who said that the apparent meaning is not intended.
هذا طائفة من هؤلاء.
This is a group of those.
الطائفة الأخرى وهم المضطربة.
The other group, they are the ones who are confused or shaky.
الذين لا يعرفون ولا يعلمون.
Those who don't know and don't have any information.
ولا يستطيعون أن يعبروا عما يعرفون ويعلمون إن كان عندهم معرفة أو علم.
And they cannot even express what they know and what they are informed of if they have any knowledge or information.
وهؤلاء يشبهون النصارى إلى حد ما.
And those they resemble the Christians to some extent.
فالنصارى مثلا,
the Christians for instance,
يقولون بأن الله عز وجل ثلاثة أقانيم.
They say that Allah عز وجل is like three parts.
وأنهم لا يريدون
three entities.
ثم لا يستطيعون أن يفسروا ما هذه الأقانيم.
Then they cannot explain those this Trinity. Anyone في حد يعرف إقنوم بالإنجليزية إيش هو؟ Can't recall that now.
الجزء اللي ما أدري إيش يفسروا يعني.
هم لا anyways, the Trinity.
وهؤلاء الذين يقولون
and those who say that
أن هذا الظاهر غير مراد,
those who say that the apparent meaning is not intended,
وأن هذا اللفظ لا يراد به ظاهره,
and that this wording, what is meant by it or what is intended by it, is other than the apparent meaning.
هم أنفسهم لا يستطيعون أن يعبروا عن مرادهم.
They themselves, they cannot express what they intend.
ولعلنا نحن الذين لا نقول بقولهم,
And maybe we who are not of the same position as they are,
نستطيع أن نعبر عنهم أكثر مما يعبروا عن أنفسهم.
We can express them or make expressions on their behalf that they cannot express themselves.
ولذلك عبر عنهم شيخ الإسلام بأنهم مضطربون.
That's why Sheikh Islam he said about them that they are shaky, confused.
هذه الطائفة الثانية.
This second group.
أما الطائفة الثالثة.
As for the third group.
فهم المتوقفون الساكتون.
Those who are pausing, those who are silent.
وهم أهل التجهيل كما ذكرهم في ما سبق.
These are the people of attributing ignorance, as was mentioned before.
الذين فوضوا هذه الألفاظ.
Those who referred the meanings of these words, the linguistic meanings even of these words.
من حيث المعنى.
Terms of meaning,
ومن حيث الكيف,
and in terms of how,
وقالوا هي محتملة.
They referred that to Allah and they said it's possible.
لعدة معان.
It is possible that these wordings that took for it to for them to carry different meanings.
وسكتوا عنها كلها.
And they were silent from all of these meanings. They didn't assign any meaning.
عليم فقط يقرؤون عليم.
So عليم knowledgeable. They just read knowledgeable.
يعلم فقط يقرؤون يعلم.
No, he knows. They just read that.
احتمال وجود المعاني لهذا لهذه العبارات.
The possibility of having meanings for these words
موجود.
Is possible according to.
ولكنهم يختفون باللفظ.
But they only suffice themselves with the wording.
ولا يثبتون أي معنى من المعاني المحتملة.
And they do not affirm any of the possible meanings.
وأما الطائفة الثانية منهم.
As for the second group of this third category.
فهم يثبتون هذه الألفاظ.
Then they affirm these wordings.
ويثبتون في نفوسهم معنى من هذه المعاني.
And they affirm within themselves a meaning of these meanings.
ويعرضون عن سائر المعاني.
But they turn away from the rest of the meanings.
فهذه الطوائف الستة.
These are the six groups.
لا يسع أي مخالف للسلف ومخالف لأهل الحديث.
Anyone who opposes the way the people of following the Salaf and the people of Hadith.
إلا أن يكون من هؤلاء.
They have no choice but to be or chance but to be one of these six.
بعضهم يقترب من أهل السنة.
Some of them get close to people of Sunnah.
وبعضهم يبتعد.
And some of them are far away.
وبعد هذا التقسيم.
After this categorization.
يلخص شيخ الإسلام ويقرر.
شيخ الإسلام summarizes and affirms.
بمنهجية ختامية.
With a methodology to seal and finish what he mentioned.
نكملها إن شاء الله بعد أن يترجم ما. ذكرنا.
We finish that inshallah after the translation.
أعانك الله تفضل.
يسر الله عز وجل.
نسأل الله أن ييسر عليك.
آمين بارك الله فيكم شيخ. He said that the collective matter or the summary of this affair is that the possible categories regarding the verses of attributes and the hadith of the attributes The possible categories are six categories. Every category, you have a group of the people of the Qibla, you have Muslims are upon that. Two groups, they say that the ayat and the ahadith of attributes of Allah, they should be taken according to their apparent meanings. Two groups, other two groups, they say that they should be taken understood against what the apparent meaning is. And two groups, they are silent. As for the first ones, those who say they should be taken according to the apparent meaning, then there are two groups. One of them, those who take them according to their apparent meaning, and they make the apparent meanings from the same type of the attributes of the created beings. So those are al-mushabbiha, those who are likening Allah to his creation. And their madhab is false, their way is false. The pious predecessors, they have rejected it. And to them, the refutation should be directed with the truth. The second group is the group that that takes those ayat and ahadith of attributes of Allah according to their apparent meaning, that is according to the apparent meaning that is suitable for the greatness of Allah. Like they take the apparent meaning of the name of Allah, Al-Alim, the All-Knowledgeable, Al-Qadir, the All-Powerful, Al-Rabb, the Lord, Al-Ilah, the God, Al-Mawjood, the one who exists, as that, Allah's entity, and the likes of that, they take them and they accept them according to the apparent meaning that is suitable for the greatness of Allah, Azza wa Jal, the greatness of Allah. For the apparent meanings of these attributes regarding the created beings, it is either an essence that is brought into existence, and regarding the created being now, is either an essence that is brought into existence or a symptom that is established within that essence. So knowledge, ability, speaking, will, mercy, pleasure, anger, and the likes of that, in reference to the servant, they are symptoms. And the face, the hand, the eye, in reference to the servant, they are bodies or body parts, limbs. So if Allah Azza wa Jal was described according to the general people who affirm the attributes for him, if Allah is described that he has knowledge, ability, speech, will, and even if this is not a symptom, because symptom only is for the created being, even if this is not a symptom, then this is, it's allowable for it what is allowable for the even though it's not a symptom, that it is allowable for it what is allowable for the attributes of the created beings, then it is allowable then that the face of Allah, his two hands, it is allowable that they are attributes that are not bodies or body parts. So this is the madhab that Al-Khattabi narrated, and other than him, from the pious predecessors. And upon this, the majority of their speech indicates. And the speech of the rest of them, the rest of the predecessors, does not go against it. And this is an affair that is clear, for the attributes, they are like the entity. So exactly like the entity of Allah is affirmed in reality, without it being like the type of the same type of the created beings, then his attributes are also affirmed in reality without them having to be from the same type of attributes of the created beings. Yani here you have the created beings, they have entity and they have symptoms. Right? And he is saying here that the knowledge and the ability and these are symptoms for the created beings, right? So this, when you are referring those attributes to Allah, knowledge and ability and all of that, these are not symptoms. They are not called symptoms, because the symptoms is only for the created beings. So likewise, exactly like his that, his entity, is not يعني, like the created beings, then his attributes, he can have those attributes without them being like the created beings' attributes. So he said, so the one who says, I cannot fathom knowledge or a hand except from the same type of knowledge and hand that are known, that is for the creation. He says, I don't know a hand or a knowledge except what is known to be a hand and knowledge for the human beings. Then he will be told, how can you fathom an entity that is different from the same type of the entities of the created beings? And it is well known that the attributes of every one who has attributes, his attributes are suitable to his entity and they are suitable to his reality. So the one who does not fathom from the attributes of the Lord, whom there is no one like him except what suits the created being, then he has gone astray in his intellect and his religion. And how beautiful it is what some of them said. If the Jahmite, he says to you, the one who denies the attribute, he says to you, how did he rise over the throne? Or how does he come down to the lower heaven? Or how is it, how are his hands? How are his two hands? The how of it. And the likes of that. He said, how beautiful it is to answer in as a reply is to ask him, how is he within himself in terms of his entity? So if he says, nobody knows what he is except he himself, nobody knows his entity except he himself, and the essence of the originator, the essence of the creator subhanahu wa ta'ala, is not known to the humans, then say to him, then knowing the how of his attribute, this necessitates knowing the how of the one who has that attribute himself. So how is it then that you will know the how of the attribute if you did not know how is the entity of the one who is described with that himself? You only know the entity and the attributes in generality, from in the general sense, according to the way that you should know it. Rather, these created things in paradise. It has been established from Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma that he said, there is nothing in this world of that which is in paradise except the names. Except the names. There is nothing in this world of the things that are in paradise except the names. And Allah informed Ta'ala that there is no soul that knows what has been hidden for them of the pleasure of the eyes. And the Prophet ﷺ informed that in paradise there is that which no eye has seen, no ear has heard of, and no heart of a human have ever imagined. Right? So those things that we know here, that things created that mentioned by name, that they have the same names in paradise and we cannot match. There is a big difference between the two. The alcohol here, the alcohol in paradise. The pomegranate here, the pomegranate in paradise. We know that there are the same names. But then, as Ibn Abbas said, there is nothing that is in this worldly life that is the same as that in paradise. It's just the names. right? So he said, so if the enjoyment of paradise, and that is from the created things that Allah created, is like that, you cannot know the how of it, then what do you think? What is your thinking about the Creator subhanahu wa ta'ala? How can you tell how he is? And here, this soul, this spirit that is within, that is inside of the children of Adam, the wise person, the intellectual person, surely knew how confused, how shaky the people about it, regarding it, yani about the soul, about the spirit. And how the texts, the revelation has held back from clarifying how it is. So in the revelation we are not told how the soul is. So wouldn't the wise person give consideration and take a lesson from the soul, which you don't know how it is? Won't you take a lesson from this by you holding back from speaking about the how of Allah Ta'ala is, although, or how the attributes of Allah Ta'ala are, although we are certain that the soul, that the spirit is in the body, we are certain of that, and that it exits from the body, and that it rises up, it ascends to the sky, and that it will be pulled out of it at the time of death, like the explicit text has spoken that. We do not exaggerate. We do not exaggerate in talking about the soul. We do not exaggerate and go to the extreme of the way the philosophers talk about it, and those who agreed with them in a way that they negated that the soul rises up and the soul comes down, and that the soul, they denied that it is connected to the body or that it is separate from the body, and they were completely mixed up regarding it, تخبطوا, regarding it, to a point that they are of the position that the soul, those philosophers, they are of the position that the soul is not from the same type as the body and its attributes. So the fact that it does not, the fact that the soul does not resemble the body, this does not negate that it will have affirmed attributes for it, for the soul itself, according to it, right? Except now, if those philosophers would explain their speech with that which agrees to the text. So they, in this way, they will be mistaken in terms of wording. And how can they do it? How can they reach this point? And we do not say that the soul, the spirit, we do not say that it is only part of the parts of the body, like the blood, like the air or the smoke, he says, for instance. Or that it is, we do not say about it, that it is just another attribute from the attributes of the body and life, and that this, we do not say that it, they are different, that they have different bodies, or that they are equal to the rest of the bodies in terms of limits, boundaries, and reality, like some of the groups of the people of philosophy, the people of intellectual rhetoric. Rather, we are certain, we are sure that the ruh, that the soul, the spirit, is a thing that exists. It is something that has its essence, its own essence that exists. That is other than the body. It's other than the body. And that it does not resemble the body. It's not the same as the body. And that it, this soul or spirit, is described with what the texts from the Quran and the Sunnah, they described it with in reality, not a metaphor. Not a metaphor. So if our position regarding the reality of the soul and its attributes is actually between those who deny it and those who liken it to the body, then what do you think then, what is the thinking then about the attributes of the Lord of the worlds? And so this soul, we do not deny it, and we do not say it is exactly like the body, right? So we are in a position that is in between. So this is about a created thing. Then what about the Allah's attributes, Allah Himself, Subhanahu wa Ta'ala? Now, he goes on to say, that's the first two groups. The second two groups are the ones who negate, those who deny the apparent meanings of the attributes. I mean, those who say that they don't have those attributes, they don't have inwardly an indication that is the attribute of Allah at all, and that Allah has no affirmed attribute. Rather, His attributes are either salbiya, negated or negative attributes, or idafiya, attributes that are referred to Him, or attributes that are murakkaba, assembled of both. And this thing he mentioned in the very beginning, right? And we did not dwell on it much. The Sheikh did not care to explain it too much because they're philosophers. But what they mean is that Allah does not have an attribute that you affirm, positive attributes, that you say He is this, He is that. Rather, they say He has either attributes that are negated. He's not like this, He's not like that, He's not like this, He's not, He doesn't have this, He doesn't have that. Or attributes that are referred to Him, attributes that are not really His, it's only known because they are related to something else, right? That's how they say they are referred or attributed to Him, but they're not really His attributes, rather they are attributed to Him, right? Or they say the third type of attributes that they affirm, attributes assembled of attributes that are negated and attributes that He doesn't have but attributed to Him because of relatively related to another thing, right? Is philosophy, so we don't have to explain all of that. But anyhow, or they attribute some of the attributes, or and they are the 7 attributes or the 8 attributes or the 15 attributes that they affirm, or they attribute or they affirm for Him ahwal or conditions, not the attributes as it is known from the oppositions or madhab or the ways of the philosophers, the people of intellectual rhetoric. And they affirm all the attributes reported in the Quran and not in the hadith. If it's in the Quran, they affirm it, but if it's in the hadith, they don't, according to what has been known from the positions of the philosophers, the people of intellectual rhetoric. So those, there are two groups. So even within them, they are differing in all of these differences. And then there are two groups in the end. A group of them, that they interpret them metaphorically, or look at them as figure of speech, figuratively interpreted or metaphorically interpreted. And they assign what is intended. Like they say, like their statement, stawa, which originally means rise over, they say it means He took over and He controlled and reigned. Or they say istawa, which originally should mean rise over, they say it means the highness of status, the highness of affair of Allah Azza wa Jal. Or they say it means His light emerging for or revealing itself for the throne. Or they say rise over the throne, istawa. They explain it as that the creation will end up to Him, Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. To other than these of the meanings that those people of philosophers, intellectual rhetoric, they say. The other group, they say, Allah knows what he intended by them. But we know that he did not intend to affirm an attribute that is like outside, outside of what we knew. So they take them, but they do not assign the meaning. But they affirm that, oh, he did not mean to affirm an attribute by that. But they don't say what. The first of them, so they agreed that they don't mean what they mean. The first group, they assigned the meaning, the false meaning. The second group, they did not assign the meaning. They just left it. But they say, we know for sure he did not affirm attributes for himself. These are the second two groups. As for the two groups that they are pausing and they are not taking a stance in this regard, then a group of them, they say, it is possible that what is intended is the apparent meaning, the intended apparent meaning that is suitable to the greatness of Allah. And it is possible that that intended meaning is what is intended is not an attribute for Allah, that may not be intended. That so it either, according to them, it is possible that the apparent meaning suitable to Allah is intended, and it is possible that it is not intended, that it's not intended that it is an attribute for Allah at all, and the likes of that. And this is the way of many of the jurists and other than them, fuqaha. And there is a group of them that they hold back from all of that, and they do not do more than reciting the Quran and reciting the Hadith, turning away with their hearts and with their tongues from all of these possible estimations. They turn away from that completely. So these are the six categories that a man cannot be outside of these six of them. And what is correct regarding... نقف هنا يا شيخ.
نعم، لا نكمل ولا تجاوزنا التاسعة. هي بقيت يعني كم من فقرة فقط.
طيب،
إلا إذا تعبوا.
طيب تفضل يا شيخ، خلينا نكمل إن شاء الله.
نكمل إن شاء الله، بارك الله فيكم.
So there isn't much that's left, so we need your patience يعني. طيب. إن شاء الله. Let's finish because this is the end of the book now.
نعم. قال والصواب، رحمة الله على شيخ الإسلام، قال والصواب في كثير من آيات الصفات والأحاديث.
He said that what is correct regarding the آيات of the and أحاديث of the attributes.
الصواب هو ما كان عليه السلف.
Is what the pious predecessors used to be upon.
من إثبات من إثبات آيات الأسماء والصفات وأحاديثها.
Of affirming the آيات and the أحاديث that mention the attributes of Allah.
وعلى منهج السلف من الإثبات والنفي.
According to the way of the pious predecessors in terms of affirming and negating.
وما ثبت الإجماع فيها.
And whatever the consensus affirms in that regard.
وأما إذا تردد المؤمن.
As for when the believer is not sure.
وأشكل عليه.
And he did not know there was ambiguity.
فهم شيء من ذلك قل أو كثر.
Understanding those would be problematic for him, whether it is there are a lot of narrations or a little.
وظن أن هناك تناقضات.
And if he thought that there are some conflicts or contradictions,
فليبادر باللجوء إلى الله عز وجل.
Then if he is in confusion, then let him rush to turn to Allah عز وجل.
وخاصة في صلاة الليل.
Especially at night prayer.
وليدعو بهذه الدعوات.
And let him make these supplications
في بداية صلاته وبين يديها.
In the beginning of his prayer and in front of it.
وذكر شيخ الإسلام الدعاء.
شيخ الإسلام mentioned the dua.
دعاء الاستفتاح في صلاة الليل.
The opening dua in the night prayer.
الذي سيترجمه فضيلة الشيخ بعد قليل.
That will be translated soon.
وفيه تجرد كامل إلى الله تبارك وتعالى.
And in it is turning with complete sincerity to Allah عز وجل.
وطلب الهداية منه.
And seeking guidance from him.
وسواء قاله قبل الشروع في الصلاة.
Whether the person says it before starting praying.
أو قاله بعد تكبيرة الإحرام في صلاة الليل.
Or he said it after the opening تكبيرة الإحرام in night prayer.
وهو الأولى.
And this is what is better.
وأظهر افتقاره إلى الله عز وجل.
After تكبير is better, and shows his need and poverty to Allah.
ودعاه وتضرع إليه.
And he called upon him and he invoked him.
وأدام النظر في كتب أهل العلم.
And he would continuously look into the books of the people of knowledge.
التي تفسر كلام الله.
Which explain the words of Allah.
وكلام النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And the words of the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم.
وكلام الصحابة والتابعين.
And the words of the companions and the those who followed them.
فالنهاية المحتمة.
So the end that is that is imperative.
والنتيجة اللازمة.
The result that is imperative and necessary.
أن الله سيهديه.
That Allah will guide him.
أما إذا لجأ.
As for the case when he turns.
إلى ألفاظ المتفلسفة والمتكلمين.
When he turns to the words of the philosophers and the people of intellectual rhetoric.
وحرص على معرفة مصطلحاتهم وقياساتهم.
He was very careful and diligent to know their terminologies and their analogies.
وما فيها من تركيبات
and
كثيرة.
whatever ways they comprise and they assemble words and terminologies they make up.
وألفاظ مشتركة.
And words that are shared.
فهي بالنسبة لقليل العلم.
So this for the one who has little knowledge.
المبتدئ.
The one who is just starting, the beginner.
الغر.
The one who is, has little knowledge. The one who can be deceived easily.
هي بمثابة السراب للعطشان.
This is like the mirage for the one who is thirsty.
وإذا نظر إليها.
The one who looks into that.
بمنهج الكتاب والسنة.
With the methodology of the book and the sunnah.
ظهر له ما كان ما هو عليه من خير.
It will appear to him what goodness in that.
لأن هذه الأشياء الباطلة.
Because these false things.
النظر إليها.
Looking in them, examining them.
يظهر حسن غيرها.
When you look at the false things, then this shows the beauty of the opposite of that.
لأن حسن الشيء يظهر ضده.
Because the beauty of something shows the opposite.
أما المتوسطين من المتكلمين والفلاسفة.
As for those who are in the middle stage, the middle course, the middle stage of the philosophers or the people of intellectual rhetoric, those who did not reach the end in terms of knowing philosophy, they are in the middle, the junior ones.
الذين يأخذون من هنا ومن هنا.
Those who take from here and there.
ولا يستقرون على منهج.
They don't get established on one methodology.
فهؤلاء لن يصلوا إلا إلى زيادة في الحيرة.
Those they will not reach except they will reach more confusion in terms of seeking knowledge.
لأن الحرص على النقص الذي هو في الأصل عندهم.
Because being careful and diligent for the deficiency that they already have,
لن يزيد النقص إلا نقصا.
It will not add the deficiency except more deficiency.
ولا يمكن أن يكون الكمال من جهة النقص.
And you cannot achieve perfection when you are continuing to be deficient.
وذكر
they are expanding in their deficiency that they already have, which is the philosophy or whatever.
فذكر شيخ الإسلام.
So Sheikh al-Islam mentioned.
أن النقص لا يأتي إلا بالنقص.
That deficiency will not result except in deficiency.
فقال أكثر ما يفسد الدنيا.
He said mostly what corrupts the worldly life.
نصف متكلم.
Either half of a philosopher.
ونصف متفقه.
Half of a jurist.
ونصف متطبب.
Half of a medical doctor.
ونصف نحوي.
Half of a grammarian.
وهذا علامة النقص.
And this is the sign of deficiency and imperfection.
فهؤلاء الذين يفسدون الأديان والبلدان والأبدان واللسان.
Those who are corrupting the religion. They are corrupting the countries. They are corrupting the tongues, and they corrupting the they are corrupting the bodies.
فيحرص الإنسان على الكلام so على one, الكمال عفوا.
So should be one should be careful and diligent to look for perfection, completeness and perfection.
في شيء
in a matter
لا بد أن يصل إليه.
The one who is diligent to complete and perfect something, inshallah, he will reach it.
فبلجوء إلى الله.
By turning to Allah.
والدعاء.
Asking Allah, supplicating Him.
والتضرع.
Invoking Him and imploring Him.
والصلاة.
Praying to Him.
والنظر في كتب أهل العلم.
And looking in the books of the people of knowledge.
هذه طرق للكمال.
These are ways leading to perfection.
فلا بد أن يصل إلى الكمال.
Inshallah, he must reach perfection.
أما إذا أراد أن يصل إلى الكمال من طريق الناقصين.
As for him wanting to reach perfection by using the methods and the ways of the deficient ones.
من المتكلمين ومن الفلاسفة ومن غيرهم.
Philosophers and people of intellectual rhetorics and rhetoric and other than them.
فهو مذموم عند أهل العلم.
Then he is dispraiseworthy according to the people of knowledge.
حججه ستتكسر وستتحطم كالزجاج.
His proofs will be broken up like glass is broken up.
وهو في الشرع مذموم.
And he is legally, according to the legislation, he is dispraiseworthy.
يستحق الضرب والإهانة.
He deserves to be hit and humiliated.
كما قال الإمام الشافعي رحمه الله تعالى.
As الإمام الشافعي رحمه الله said.
وذكر شيخ الإسلام أثرا في هذا.
And he mentioned the statement from Imam الشافعي.
سيترجمه لكم فضيلة الشيخ.
We will translate.
ومن حيث القدر.
And in terms of predestination.
فهو مذموم أيضا.
He is also dispraiseworthy.
فإذا نظرت إليه بنظر الشرع أوجبت له العقوبة.
So if you look at this person who's confused, if you look at him with the aspect and the eye of legislation, then he must be punished. He deserves punishment.
وإذا نظرت إليهم بعين القدر,
and if you look at them, those confused people, from the aspect of predestination, of the eye of the predestination,
الذي نؤمن بخيره وشره,
which we believe in its good and its bad,
رحمتهم,
then you look at them with mercy.
وأشفقت عليهم.
You feel pitiful and sorry for them.
فإذا تبين لك,
so if it became clear to you,
أنهم أعطوا ذكاء ولم يؤتوا ذكاء,
that they have given cleverness, but they haven't been given purity.
وأعطوا فهوما ولم يعطوا علوما.
And they were given understanding, but they were not given information, knowledge.
ولم يستفيدوا من نعم الله عز وجل في أسماعهم وأبصارهم.
And they did not benefit from the bounties of Allah upon them in terms of their hearing and their seeing.
رحمتهم وأشفقت عليهم.
Do you feel sorry for them and you feel pitiful for them?
وهذا حال أهل السنة.
And this is the way of أهل السنة. This is their condition.
مع المخالفين.
With those who oppose them.
فهم لا يتمنوا لأحد هلاكا.
They do not wish for anyone to be destroyed.
ولا فسادا ولا إفسادا.
Nor corruption, no causing of corruption.
ولكنهم يرحمون الخلق.
But they have mercy on the creation.
ويتمنون لهم النجاة.
And they hope for them safety and salvation.
ويحرصون على ذلك.
And they are diligent for that, to achieve that.
ولكنهم يؤمنون بحديث القبضتين أيضا.
But they also believe in the hadith of the two grips or the two handfuls.
هؤلاء الجنة وهؤلاء النار.
This grip for the paradise, the other one for the fire.
وكلما كثر علم العالم.
And the more the knowledge of a scholar increases.
ومعرفته بمنهج السلف.
And his knowledge of the way of the pious predecessors increases.
وعلمهم وخبرتهم.
And their knowledge and their expertise.
علم مدى الهداية التي هداه الله تبارك وتعالى إليها.
Then he will know the how great is the guidance that Allah guided him to.
والتي يجب عليه أن يحرص على الوصول إليها.
Which he must be careful and diligent to reach.
ثم ختم شيخ الإسلام هذه الفتوى.
Then Sheikh al-Islam sealed this verdict.
بالدعاء إلى الله عز وجل.
By making dua to Allah عز وجل.
والتضرع إليه.
And imploring him.
أن يهدينا إلى سواء الصراط.
To guide us to the straight path.
صراط الذين أنعم عليهم.
The path whom Allah has favored.
غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين.
Not those who earned the wrath and not those who went astray.
ونحن ندعو بهذا الدعاء.
And we make the same دعاء.
والحمد لله رب العالمين.
And all praise is due to Allah, the Lord of the world.
نعم تفضل.
شيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية عليه رحمة الله said, and what is correct regarding many of the verses and the ahadith, the verses and the ahadith of attributes, is to be definitive, with the way that is affirmed, like the ayat and the ahadith that indicate that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is above His throne. And it is known that the way that is correct in this and the likes of it, with the proofs or indication of the book and the sunnah and the consensus upon that, an indication that it is not possible to be negated. And in some of this, and in some of those verses, in some of this, maybe يغلب على الظن, يعني you would be mostly thinking that although there would be some possibility of the opposite, and the believer might be shaky or hesitant in this regard. This is according to what he is given of the knowledge and faith. And the one whom Allah does not make for him light, then he will have no light. And the one who is having ambiguity regarding any of this, he's not sure, or other than that, then let him call upon Allah in what Muslim has narrated in his Sahih from Aisha radiallahu anha, that she said that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to, when he used to pray at night, when he stands up to pray at night, he used to say, O Allah, the Lord of Jibra'il, Mika'il and Israfil, the originator of the heavens and the earth, the knower of the hidden and the seen, you are the judge between you judge between your servants regarding that which they used to differ about. Guide me to that which the people have differed about of the truth by your permission, for surely you guide whomever you wish to a straight path. In one narration or version of Abu Dawood, it says that he used to make the takbir in his salah, then he would say that that is for the night prayer. So if the servant showed need and poverty to Allah and he called upon him, and he continuously looked into the book of Allah and the in the speech of Allah, the speech of the messenger, and the speech of the companions and the tabi'een, the followers, the second generation, and the speech of the Muslim imams, then the door or the way of guidance will be opened up for him. Then he said, then if he, yani the person, has had experience of the ends of these trials, or what happened to the philosophers and the people of rhetoric. They embarked and they indulged themselves into philosophy and intellectual rhetoric. He knows the end of that embarkment. He knows the end of it in this regard. And this is something that he mentioned in the beginning, that they said the end is like a tie and they couldn't reach anything, right? So he said, if the one knows the end that those philosophers have reached in this regard, and he knew that the majority of what they call proof is actually a misconception or a doubt, and he saw that most of what they depend on, it turns into, in reality, it turns into a claim that has no reality whatsoever, or that it is a misconception that is assembled from a false analogy or a collective issue that cannot be sound except partially, or a claim of consensus that has no reality whatsoever, or that they are holding on in terms of a way or proof, they are holding on to terms or wordings that are shared. So then this, if it was assembled with يعني, all of this confusion that those philosophers have gone through, the wordings and all of that, this, if it is assembled with wordings that are many, that are long, that are very strange, right? From those, they are assembling those long, strange words. For those who did not know their terminology, this will make the miskeen, يعني, will make the inexperienced, this one who is deceived and inexperienced, it will make him imagine what the mirage will make the thirsty person imagine, right? If he sees those long and strange words that they make, the terminologies, he will think that they are very knowledgeable. And then he will come to it and it will happen like the mirage. It will not quench your thirst. So the one, if he sees that, and if the person sees what they are upon, then he will be increased in faith and knowledge of what the book and the sunnah have come with. For the opposite will make the beauty of the opposite emerge, show up, right? You can tell the opposites by the opposites. So what makes the beauty of something show up and emerge is when you see the opposite of it, the horrible thing, right? And the one who is knowledgeable, more knowledgeable of the falsehood, the one who is more knowledgeable of the falsehood, he will be towards the truth, he will be more aggrandizing the truth. He will be much more, if you know the falsehood, then you will be aggrandizing the truth much more and giving it its due right much more. And according, the one who knows, he was more knowledgeable of the falsehood, he will be aggrandizing the truth more, and he will be also knowing the value and the worth of the truth even more when he is guided to it, when he is guided to it. He said, as for those who are in the middle stage of philosophy, they did not reach the ends of it, those who are in the middle stage of learning philosophy, of the people of intellectual rhetoric, so it is feared for them that which is not feared for those who did not enter it at all. And also it is feared for them more than the one who entered into it and got it to its end. That is because the one who did not enter it at all, then he is in safety and security. He is in well-being from it. And the one who reached its end, then he knew the end of it. He knew the objective behind it. Yani that it doesn't make him reach anything. So he doesn't. We are not afraid of him, of anything else for him. So if the truth shows up to him, while he is thirsty to it, he will accept it. Yani the one who reached the end and he knew that philosophy does not give him any knowledge, now he knows if he saw the truth, he will follow it. But the one who is in the middle, the one who is in the middle of philosophy, of learning philosophy, then he imagines by what he receives of those statements that are taken by blind imitation to the one who is whom he is aggrandizing. Yani he is just blindly imitating his sheikh whom he is looking up to, and his sheikh who is like making those big long strange yani statements, right, that he doesn't get. And he says, and some people have said mostly those who corrupt the worldly life the most are half of a philosopher, half of a jurist, half of a medical doctor or claiming medical doctor, claiming to be a medical doctor, and half of a grammarian, a person who is dealing with grammar. This one, he corrupts the religions, and this one, he corrupts the countries, and this one, he corrupts the bodies, and this one, he corrupts the tongue, the language. And the one who knows that the people of intellectual rhetoric, متكلمين, of the philosophers and other than them, they are mostly, they are in a statement that is disagreeing. They always disagree with each other, the philosophers. They always agree with this with each other. As in the Quran, Dhariyat 8 and 9. They are, he is quoting, using that those statements about them. It's originally in the Kuffar. They are in a contradictory, they are in a statement that's conflicting each other. And those who are يُؤْفَكُ عَنْهُمْ أُفِكُ, those who are turned away, they will be turned away by it. And those whom Allah judged that they will be turning away from it, they will turn away. They will end up as Allah said. So the one who knows that the philosophers, they are mostly, they are differing like that and they are turning away from the truth, he knows that the one who is clever amongst them and the one who is wise amongst them, he will know that what he is upon and what he is saying, yani someone who got involved in philosophy, and he sees all of these differing statements within the philosophers, right? The one who is smart amongst them, the one who is wise, he knows that he, regarding what he is saying, he does not have sure knowledge about what he is saying. And that his proof is not really a clear proof. And that the proof that he is upon, actually, they are those proofs that they are upon, they are actually like what is said, line of poetry, they are weak proofs, that they are, they resemble glass. You think that they are true, you think they are truthful, those evidences, you think they are true, but then each one of them is breaking and broken. And each proof that he uses is broken within itself and it breaks. It's by itself, breaking and broken, or shattering and shattered, right? Shattering and shattered, right? All of these proofs are shattering and shattered. And he knows, the one who's knowledgeable, the one who has insight regarding them, he knows that they are from one aspect, they deserve what Al-Shafi'i radiallahu anhu said, when he said, my judgment regarding the people of philosophy, intellectual rhetoric, my judgment regarding them is that they should be beaten by shoes and sticks. Yani jarid is the branches of the palm trees. They should be whipped by those, the philosophers, they should be whipped by branches of palm trees and by shoes. And they should be taken and shown, yani circled. They should be taken and circled with between tribes and people, and it should be said, this is the punishment of the one who abandons the book and the sunnah and turns to or embarks upon indulging himself in the kalam, in the philosophy or the speech of the people of the intellectual rhetoric. From another aspect, if you look at them from the eye or from the aspect of the predestination, when you see that confusion and confusion have taken over them, has taken over these people, and the shaitan has overpowered them and taken them over, you, from this aspect, you feel merciful towards them. You want to be kind towards them. They have been given smartness or cleverness, but they haven't been given purity. They have been given understanding, but they have not been granted knowledge. They have been given hearing and eyesight and hearts. But then, as Allah said, Surah Al-Ahqaf 26, that their hearing, this ayah is about the kuffar, the disbelievers, but they share that with them. They have been given hearing, eyesight, and hearts. But then their hearings and eyesights, neither their hearing, their eyesight, nor their hearts benefited them at all. They does not benefited them at all in anything, since they used to disbelieve in the signs or in the verses of Allah, ayatullah, and it has happened to them, it has taken over them that which they used to mock at. Yani the punishment took them over, the punishment that they were mocking at, that's what happened to them exactly. And the one who is knowledgeable in these affairs, then it will become crystal clear to him the cleverness and the sharpness of the pious predecessors, their knowledge and their expertise when they warned against kalam, when they warned against intellectual rhetoric, philosophy, and they forbade it and they dispraised its people and they blamed them or critiqued them and they disgraced them. And he knows that the one who seeks guidance in other than the book and the sunnah, he will not be increased by that from Allah except being far and far away. So we ask Allah the Great to guide us to his straight path, the path of those whom he favored, not the ones who earned wrath and not the ones who went astray. Ameen. Oh Allah, answer that. And all praise is due to Allah, the Lord of the world, and his salah, salutation, and his salam, his peace be upon Muhammad, the seal of the prophets, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and his family and his companions, all of them. And with this, we are at the end of this treatise. الحمد لله رب العالمين.
الحمد لله رب العالمين. معذرة إليكم يا إخواني.
I apologize to you, my brothers.
أنني أطلت عليكم.
That I took long.
ولكن.
But then.
رجاءنا عند الله تبارك وتعالى.
Our hope with Allah عز وجل.
أن يتقبل منا.
That He will accept from us.
ما يمكن أننا قد أوصلناه إليكم بحق.
Whatever we were able to make reach to you with the truth of the truth.
فيعلم الله عز وجل.
Allah knows عز وجل.
أنني ما ادخرت جهدا.
That I did not save any and did not keep away any effort.
من خلال كتابي المشروح.
Through the book that I explained.
أو ذهني وعقلي في الاستحضار.
Or my mind and my intellect in, you know, trying to explain.
أو قلمي وبناني في التلخيص.
Or even my pen and my finger in trying to summarize.
أو اختيار ألفاظي.
Or choosing my wordings.
إلا أن أصل معكم.
I didn't want except to reach with you.
إلى معرفة الله تبارك وتعالى.
To knowing Allah عز وجل.
بأسمائه وصفاته.
With his names and his attributes.
وتقديس ذاته سبحانه
and
وتعالى.
To hold Allah سبحانه وتعالى to be removed from any deficiency, to hold him to be holy and sacred.
وهو أعظم وأشرف علم.
And this is the greatest and the most noble branches of knowledge.
يسعى إليه العبد.
That the servant would strive and labor to achieve.
وهو العلم بالله تبارك وتعالى.
And that is the knowledge of Allah تبارك وتعالى.
التي تؤدي به.
Which will lead him to.
إلى إصلاح عمله.
Which will lead him to rectifying and reforming his deeds.
وكم سبقنا من أناس.
And how many of the people that have preceded us
على مدى أكثر من 700 سنة
over the span of about 700 years
وهم يقرؤون هذا الكتاب
while they are reading this book
ويشرحونه
and they explain it
في مختلف الأمصار والأعصار
in different countries and different times
وكم شرح هذا الكتاب من علماء وأئمة سبقوا.
How many of the scholars and imams that have explained this in the past?
واستمع لشرحه أيضا علماء وأئمة.
How many of scholars and imams have also listened to the explanation of this book?
فلو خرجنا من هذا الكتاب.
So if we ended up by studying this book.
بغير فهم لشيء منه.
With nothing understood from this book, if we ended up not understanding anything of this book,
فحسبنا.
Then suffice us
أن نحشر وأن نذكر.
That we'll be gathered and we will be mentioned.
والملائكة تحصي وتسجل.
And the angels are listing and writing down and recording.
أننا بذلنا جهدنا ووسعنا.
That we spent all our efforts and abilities.
في أن نفهم كلام السلف.
To understand the words of the pious predecessors.
الذي فسروا فيه كلام الله.
In which they explained the words of Allah.
وكلام نبيه صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And the words of his prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
في أسماء الله وصفاته.
Regarding the names and attributes of Allah.
وأثبتوا ما أثبتوا له.
And they affirmed whatever they affirmed for him.
ونفوا عنه ما نفى عن نفسه أو نفى عنه نبيه.
They negated from him whatever he negated or his messenger negated from him.
وكما قيل شرف العلم من شرف المعلوم.
And as they said, the nobility of the branch of knowledge is a branch of the nobility of the one that you are studying or the thing that you are studying, the matter. The piece of knowledge that you are studying.
والعلم بالله.
Knowledge of Allah.
هو أشرف علم يمكن أن يتحصل عليه الإنسان.
Is the most noble type of knowledge that a human being can achieve.
أو يسعى إلى تحصيله.
Or even strive hard to achieve.
ولو لم يحصله.
Even if he didn't achieve it.
فكثير من الناس.
Many of the people.
بدأوا بتعلم أشياء.
They started by learning things
وانقطعوا دون تحصيلها.
And they ceased and stopped before achieving
ولكنهم
them.
لم يفتهم.
But they did not miss
شرف السعي والتحصيل.
The nobility of striving and laboring hard to achieve.
فجزاكم الله خيرا على صبركم علينا.
So may Allah reward you all for you being patient with us.
وحلمكم.
And being forbearing.
ونسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن لا يجعل هذا اللقاء آخر لقاءات بكم.
And we ask Allah Azza wa Jal not to make this sitting the last of the sittings with you.
إن كان في ذلك خير لنا ولكم.
If there is in that goodness for you and for us.
والحمد لله رب العالمين.
And all praises due to Allah, the Lord of the world. Barakallahu fikum, Sheikh. Jazakum Allah khairan, ahsan alaykum.
Allah yahfazkum.
Ahsan Allah alaykum.
Allah yajzikum al-khair wa barik fikum.
Inshallah, al-ghad, يعني بعد العصر. وغدا اسألوا ما تشاءون إن شاء الله. إيش رأي الشيخ؟
لا بأس. لا بأس.
Tomorrow you can ask what you wish. After عصر and let's go on. We start with questions related to the topic, inshallah. Right? And then we move on to other things. Please write down if you have questions, write them down. So let's deal with the questions pertaining to the topic, then we move from this to any other topic that you wish. Right? The Sheikh said, no problem, he's ready. But write them down so we can make use of the time as much as we can, inshallah. And write legibly and clearly. If you write like this, the reader will not be able to read it. That's me.